Good afternoon. I'm Steve Spencer from SMB Capital, and today's trading lesson is one way to spot a long-term bottom in a stock. And in a bull market, one of the things you want to do is find sector and market-leading stocks that have come off quite a bit and identifying spots where they're likely to bottom, and then using some trading techniques and price action to get confirmation. And so the stock we're going to look at today is Michael Kors, KORS. And this is a leader in high fashion. And actually reminds me a little bit of Lululemon, which over the last few years got hammered, was beaten down, and then over the last few months has had a huge bounce. And so the other day when I was watching Kors in the pre-market, I saw a very distinctive price action. I actually shared that via stock twits. And I said that what I was seeing is indicative of stocks bottoming. And so that's the first part of the equation, identifying likely price action and scenarios where stocks will bottom, and then following through and making some trades. And so what I'll do is, when a stock has fresh news and it's down 30 to 40% from the high, in this case, Kors was, and it's coming into, and by the way, 30 to 40% is what I find market-leading, sector-leading stocks, momentum-type stocks, they will come down in that range, and quite often they'll bottom quite frequently. In fact, in 2014, in the spring, if you look at some of the leading momentum names, they came down around that percentage before making new highs in July. And so this had a very nice uptrend. If we look at the longer-term chart, in 2013, in the last year or so, it was coming down. That bottom blue line is kind of the area which is about 40% from the high. And you know, as it comes in closer to that area, look for a bottom, and then look for that longer-term downtrend to break. And that's the next part of the equation, where once that longer-term downtrend breaks, not only are we going to look for a short-term pop back up to resistance, we're going to change the way we view it and look for longer-term swing and position trades to trade to much higher prices. And so what I want you to take a look at here is the pre-market chart. And what I noticed was, after going down to the low 60s, almost about 40% from the all-time high, massive volume came in, and quite early. Normally in pre-market trading, volume doesn't usually come in until about 8 o'clock. But in this case, some volume really started to come in around 7:30, and by 8 o'clock it already bounced about $4 or $5, and that caught my attention. Now, the second part of the equation for this one is, I know that 68 and 70 are important longer term levels. And so I have a stock that very heavy volume has come in the pre-market. It's bounced up to around $68. And I know when the market opens, if more volume comes in and it makes an opening drive, and that's what it did in this case, and it starts spending time above that 68 level, that's something that I want to be long. And so you can see I highlighted from the pre-market, that pre-market resistance, which also happened to be 68, a longer-term important level. It drove heavy volume on the open. It pulled back. It went a little bit below there, and was below there for about 15, 20 minutes, but came right back up to the level, got tight, very tight at the level, and when it starts to go up from there, you want to be long. The next, and this is an intraday trade at this point, we're looking to see if it can go back up to 70 and what happens at the 70 level. And then if it closes strong around 70, which it did, this is a swing trade and can even become a position trader for a longer time frame. And so what this does, as short-term traders, where we can identify important prices and tight time frames and price action, we not only can make a trade intraday, but we can change the risk reward for a swing trade and a position trade by understanding price action and getting in at the best prices and observing that behavior that confirms our thesis. Our thesis is the pre-market price action of a stock, a sector-leading stock that's down between 30 and 40% when buyers come in, that could be possibly a bottom. Now we're looking intraday for price action to confirm that. So I wanted to share, for those of you out there who are swing traders, position traders, I want to kind of share the two-day price action. And what we saw was, on day one, you can see that opening drive, and it went up to about $70 a share, had a pretty deep pullback. On that next day, what we want to see is shallow pullback, take out the get back above the prior day support area, and then eventually trend up and close strong. And when we do that, this becomes a really nice longer term trade. Hopefully you learned something. Thanks for joining us.